Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. I am glad to be here. Hope you are too. I want to cover your hot dog stand not making money or not making enough money, or you're not satisfied with what it's making. Either way, you need more money and you're going, what do I do? And most people run to more menu items and then they start spending some money on Facebook, and there's so many alternatives and so many different variables to this question. And so I'll cut to the chase real quick for you is I need more information to answer that. And the reason I said that is there's been two people recently in the YouTube comments that have said, Ben, I need help, help, help. One of them said, help, help, help. My cart's not making any money. I don't know what to do. Well, the truth is, and I don't mean this to sound cocky or arrogant, but there's no luck. There's no chance in this. Can you have some luck? Yes. But it doesn't determine your success. It may speed up your success, but it doesn't determine your success in this, because this is not a luck or chance business. It's I want to dig a hole, and it's a three-step process. Get a shovel, put it in the ground, scoop out dirt, you have a hole. There's your hole. Works for everybody, okay? So that will work for everybody. Could I get lucky and dig in an area that has no roots, no rocks, and real soft soil, and get my scoop out quicker than you? Absolutely. But you can still do the same process and get the same results. So doesn't matter about you worked harder for it. That's inevitable either way. People work different. You know, sometimes you just luck of the draw and you dig in and you've got more rock in your hole and it takes you longer to get the shovel into the ground. But I can go into anybody who go to anybody's location in the country and go, man, you're having trouble. Okay. And I can take it over that day and I'll make it profitable every day, and it'll make more money than it has been making. Now, why is that? Why is there some magic that I'm carrying around? No, I don't have a magic crow's foot or any kind of feather with me or magic anything. It's just the fact that you have to know certain things to make that happen. And a lot of people get discouraged, and I don't blame you, because you're going, dang, I just ain't making enough money. Man, I go out and I make $100 and it just ain't enough. I need to be making 200, 300 a day or 500 a day or whatever it is. It can be done, and it's a matter of a few things. And some of these things may not apply to you in your cart situation, but they'll apply to someone else or vice versa. So one of the things is location, okay? But I typically don't jump to location first, because if you're consistent at a location, you will make money. If you're marketing it correctly, and when I say marketing, I don't mean spending money, but if you're marketing it correctly and you're doing all the other things you're supposed to do, then it's going to be successful, period. You could be off on a back street somewhere. That I was on a 60 mile an hour highway, it's 55, but everybody does 60, 65, in front of a tire shop, and still had traffic stopping to get off the road to get to my hot dog cart. Why? Because typically it's hard to stop traffic like that. When I teach people about locations, I teach you, hey, look at your location, make sure that people can easily get in and out, that they can see you in enough time to slow down safely to get to you. I wasn't in that boat, but I still got them there. So there's all these things that play a part in it, and you may be going, well, that's boring and it's pain. But the problem is if you get it, if you get this, you will end up being way more successful. So your $80 days turn into $400 days, and your $400 days turn into $800 days, all because of you applying some principles. And you may be shortchanging yourself on two or three of these, or maybe just one. And it's all the difference in the world. So that's how I know. I'm confident enough to know that me or Jason Brown or Mark Lawler or Ken Packer could go to any cart on the planet that's struggling and make it make money just by making a few tweaks and changes. But we have to know that information. We have to know what information. So what I've asked in the past when I've done cart critiques, which you'll find on here, where I've critiqued somebody who sent me the information and also offered to allow me to put it online, I go through it and figure out what the problem is. So I look at Google Maps, I look at Google Earth, I look at their signs, I'll ask them to get pictures. So what I want to see is the whole surrounding with you there. I want to see what that looks like. What's your marketing like? Where have you been posting? How does anybody know you're here other than the people passing by? Doesn't mean you can't make it, but why not add 20% to your day because you made one Facebook post last week? Makes a big difference. So so what you've got is location. Then you've got your menu. So could you, okay, I had a couple a while back, and they were in Kentucky, and they were a young couple, and they had a couple kids, and they were gung-ho, and they did their shirt, they made shirts, they had name tags, they looked professional. But guess what they did? They picked a food category that didn't fit to their surroundings. So they picked menu items that were all organic, vegan hot dogs, vegan buns, vegan. Well, they were in Kentucky in an area that people like cornbread, mashed taters, and Spam, like me. So I wasn't going to stop at a vegan hot dog cart. They had such a small fishing pond to fish out of, where when you're a vendor, you want the biggest pond to fish out of. You want almost everybody to want your food, or at least like it. And so that was their problem. Now, just changing their menu solved everything for them, because they had everything else nailed. The problem is they had the menu wrong. So that could be it for you. Or it could be pricing. You could be priced wrong and for your area. And you may be going, yeah, but I'm the cheapest out there. Well, cheapest doesn't mean best. Okay, and I've said this before, but I started in this business and helped thousands of vendors, tens of thousands of vendors. But one of the vendors that I was helping, and we'd communicate and talk, he started helping me because I'm still vending. And he goes, Ben, you need to raise your prices. And I'm going, dude, I'm in Sevierville, Tennessee. People can't afford it, man. I'm in a poor area. I mean, we have our tourist area, but what I'm saying is, for the most part, everybody just labors for the tourist area, you know, so they're not paid much. And so I was like, I can't raise my prices. Well, it took him a year to talk me into raising my prices. I raised my prices from $2 to $3 for a hot dog. It was unheard of. Okay, you can go into a fine restaurant and get a cheaper hot dog. And here I am selling Oscar Mayer Wieners or Nathan's or Ballpark or whatever. At the time, I was selling Sam's Club Baker and Chef brand. But either way, an inexpensive hot dog I'm selling for $3. Why? Because Jason said I needed to. So I finally did it. And guess what happened? Immediately, I started making more sales. Not just sales, but more money, because now my profit went up because of that. So your menu, your pricing of your menu items could be wrong and creating a little bit of a dip. It's never my go-to to change anyone's pricing, because typically it's something else, and it's one of the other things I'll cover. But pricing does have an effect. So somebody that's making $80 a day, let's say they're selling 45 hot dogs a day. I'm gonna make this easier for my head. 50 hot dogs a day, okay? And they're $2 a piece. Now they're making $3 a piece. That extra dollar is 100% profit, along with the profit they had at the $2 price. So now they've made another $50. So a $80 day, or whatever, if it would be a $100 day, now has become a $150 day. So they just had a 50% increase in profits just by one simple thing. But the thing is if, like in my case, I sold more hot dogs. Why would that be? Well, I can go down this rabbit hole forever, but the bottom line is, people's psyche is, hey, do you want, I got 10 tacos for a dollar, or do you want a $4 taco that you're looking at? I'm going to take the $4 taco. Even if I got to buy three of them to fill up, I ain't buying 10 cent tacos. Why? Because I have no clue how they're doing that. Scare me to death. And so sometimes you're too cheap. My issue was I was too cheap. So that was just one of my problems. Okay. Appearance is another problem. Sometimes it's easy to get into a lazy-minded, and I don't mean go out there in a bow tie. We've got a guy that does bow tie. You know, he wears a bow tie and rides a unicycle, and he makes good money with hot dog vending. But you don't have to do that, as long as you're clean and neat. If you're clean and neat, I always carried an extra shirt, always carried an extra apron, and I my appearance was professional. And so I still was as country as cornbread. I still walked around in cowboy boots. But I didn't have a ripped shirt with mustard stains, because it's the shirt I wore yesterday to my daughter's, you know, whatever party, and got mustard on it. So the bottom line is by being more concerned about the way you look and your appearance, being clean cut, clean shaven also works. And I'll go one other step here with you on this appearance. I can take a husband and wife, no matter who in the country, and I can have the husband work for a week and then the wife work for a week. The wife will make more. Why? Because men and women are more comfortable going up to someone unknown if it's a female. Okay? We're more comfortable. We feel more at ease. Okay? Where we also know that most of us have moms and wives or girlfriends who do most of the cleaning. So what do we think of? We know they're more clean. So it typically, not all the time, typically lends to a better business model if a female's there running it. I'm not saying you have to do. I'm pointing out the fact your appearance lends a lot to whether people feel comfortable coming up to you. Okay. The other thing is your attitude. So I can tell somebody's attitude from a distance, just like you can. You can kind of read their face. It's how we notice if they're mad, ticked off, you know, in disbelief, disgruntled, whatever. If you go out there and you're kind of pissy, you're just having a bad day, you don't even know, I don't even want to have to tell you about it, my day was so bad, and you have that, you're wearing that on your face and in your attitude and the energy you exude, people will feel that and they won't come. And it's why smiles will change lives. Just smiling. Okay, they've done social experiments where people just smile at somebody and then interview that person down the street and go, hey, I noticed you smiled back there. And he goes, well, somebody smiled at me. And then they go, yeah, it made me feel better. I just felt better. And it's because it has something to do with our chemical brain goo. We end up feeling better because we were smiled at. And so if you use your smile and your attitude exudes positiveness, you will pull in more customers because they'll feel it. They'll just feel it. They'll not only see it, but they'll feel it. And if you're clean and kind, it just works. It's like snowballs. And people love to come up there. I got to where I had people that would come up, pull up a chair. They wanted to hang out at the hot dog cart because it was just fun. And that's and every day, the same people were coming for lunch. And they might meet some new people. Somebody from Florida's pulling in through Pigeon Forge and going to stop and get a hot dog. And now they get to meet, you know, Bo Diddley and Junior sitting there with their guitars. That attitude and that appearance will attract more customers. So if you're not doing that, we used to have a guy in our Vendors United group, was in there for years. Okay. One of his, he just kind of had like a sad look about him. You know, he just looked, kind of just upset or depressed, not mad, just kind of depressed, kind of lackadaisical, kind of like just, you know, well, we talked to him. His wife sent me videos of him working the cart and just a couple videos of just, and so I went through that and I noticed he doesn't look inviting because he kind of looks like, what are you on it? Oh, you won't catch up. All right. What are you next? You know, that kind of mentality. Well, most people ain't there because they ain't that you're the only place they could ever get a hot dog ever again. They're there because it's a nostalgic item. A nostalgic, if you have a cart, it's nostalgic. If you're squeezing lemonade, nostalgic. You're making funnel cakes. It reminds me of being at the county fair with my papaw. And so you end up attracting those people, and people are stopping for those reasons. Well, if you look kind of blah, they're going to feel kind of blah and probably walk on by you, okay? You've probably been to a McDonald's, Starbucks, Hardee's, something, right? And go through the drive-thru and been treated kind of like, what do you want? How much? Okay. How many of those? Is that the end of your order? Or they ask you 19 times before you finish the order, if you're finished with your order. Does that complete your order? No, I'm in the middle of my order. How about you not talk? And then when I finish my order, I'll tell you I'm done, or I'll blow a whistle for you or toot my horn. But how you feel at that, and you kind of just, we've come accustomed to it. We just deal with it because we want the convenience. Hot dog carts isn't always about the convenience. It's about the nostalgia, the feel of working that cart and being a part of that. And so although it's great food, and for a good amount of money, as far as it's a budget-friendly item for everybody that wants to eat. And so it is just a perfect avenue to use your charisma and attitude to brighten other people's days, and it will make them more welcoming to share that information with friends. They're down at the courthouse getting their tags updated or their taxes updated or something, and they go, man, that guy down there at the 5th and Main, he's good and so dang friendly. And you'll hear stuff like that over time. And it's because it spreads. And it just spreads. And it's almost organic. And so, not almost organic, it is organic. So, one of the other things is consistency. And consistency hurts, being inconsistent has hurt a lot of vendors. And so, we'll have vendors in our Vendors United group, okay, who will come in there. And they'll be doing good. And then they won't be doing good. There's one on my videos on here. And I don't film him anymore, but you'll see him on here, okay? And he was struggling in business. I went and helped him. He's one of our Vendors United members. I went and helped him because he lived nearby, you know, in a neighboring town. And so I went and helped him. And his business, I had him change and tweak at some things. I didn't change nothing. I didn't change his menu. I didn't change his pricing even. I just tweaked a few things, and he became hugely successful. Well, then about 3 years into it, he's telling, you know, he talked to me often, and he talks to the other group members in Vendors United, and he's saying, man, it's just not as good as it used to be. It's just not, you know. I went Tuesday, and normally Tuesdays are pretty good, and I haven't been in the last 3 weeks, but this Tuesday I went, and it wasn't even good. Not many people showed up. Well, what I got to noticing is consistency went down. And when I say consistency of just showing up, his even went down to the fact of, I ain't going to put up my banners today. You know, it's kind of windy. I just don't want to deal with that. People already know who I am. And you become complacent. So you kind of like, well, I got enough customers. People already know I'm here. Why to go to the trouble of taking 5 minutes out of my day to put up this swooper flag? Well, you do that because people get used to seeing it. McDonald's probably could get away without them golden arches. They could just put up a decal, you know, up by the road said McDonald's with an arrow, and you just know where to turn. But they still, they keep it consistent. Nationwide, worldwide, they keep those golden arches because it's something we know and trust and understand. We may not trust them, but you know what I mean. We know we're going to get the same crappy food every time. Let's go from consistency on to the, as far as showing up. So if you're going to start showing up somewhere, and I've had some vendors call me before and are complaining about, you know, sales are down or whatever. And I'll go, when are you there? Well, I tried it Tuesday. That wasn't so good. So I went Wednesday, and then, I moved down the road a little bit and I tried it there. I think that was Friday. And then the next week I went on a Monday. Well, people don't know when you're going to be there. It's kind of like it's hit and miss. Does that work for some people? Yes, but they created a social media following first. They didn't just start being willy-nilly with their locations and hours without having a following, because nobody's going to know. So, yes, you could get the random people to come up, but you'll have those beginner day type deal where, dang, I never knew there was a hot dog cart in front of Ace. Well, probably won't ever be there again because he's going to be down, you know, across town tomorrow because he ain't consistent. That doesn't mean you can't create consistency by being at multiple places. I went to three different places, and I worked those places. Sometimes I had a fourth place. So I made it so that, but every Tuesday I was here, and every Thursday I was here. And so I did that intentionally because people get used to it. And it's why I go back, you know how I said earlier, this could go down rabbit holes, but I'm going to just touch on this real quick. I said to keep records. So if you're keeping records, even on a little yellow pad, you got a little yellow pad and you're keeping records and you're going, okay, Monday I worked here, Tuesday I worked here, the hours, the time and the type of day it was, rainy, sunny, blah, blah, blah. Well, you could look back in a month and go, dang, I tell you what, Tuesdays kick butt out in front of Tractor Supply. I ain't giving up Tuesdays. I'm going to keep Tuesdays there because Thursdays there suck. I'm going to just do Tuesdays there, and I'm going to find me a new location for Thursday. Well, those little records keep help you maintain consistency and more profitable. So the other one was attitude, which I already covered basically with your appearance. And so I won't go into that anymore. But I did want you to know that it's not a matter of luck and chance. The successful vendors, if you came into Vendors United, you'll see the successful vendors. They're the ones helping other people and happy, and they're kicking butt. And you go, well, why can't I be like that? And then you talk to somebody like, you know, one of the other vendors, and you go, well, how come you ain't like he is? Well, there's different reasons for that, but typically it's one of these things. It's just one of these things that I just went through. Location, menu, pricing, appearance, consistency, attitude. Those are the things that make it work. I could take out location completely, as I said at the beginning, and solve the problem with one of the others. Because I guarantee you, any location where people are breathing, you can get them to you. It may take a little bit of marketing finesse, and you may go, well, Ben, how do I do that? Well, I've got videos on that too. They're all free, okay? So you can go in there and find out how Ben markets on Facebook or Instagram or Pinterest even with short, tiny little videos for a vendor that just shows him putting ketchup on a hot dog, and it just looks cool with some background music. And it's, oh, you got to get this at Doggone Good Dogs down at, you know, 5th and Main. And all of a sudden, it just drives people because it's interactive. When vendors I follow some vendors on TikTok. They do a great job showing the day-to-day. Well, dang, look here, we got a flat tire, so we're going to be late today. This is just a part of life. You get flat tires, and they go through even the bad days. They talk about that stuff. They go, man, we had to, you know, we got there and it started raining, blew the canopy over, and blah, 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 blah. Well, people can relate to that. What's the most watched thing on TV? Reality TV, okay? Or fake reality TV. Either way, it's reality kind of ish. And we watch it. So why wouldn't your marketing be reality? But the truth. You know, show them, hey, I'm testing out some new chili. If you look at this, consistency of this one, consistency of that one. 15-second video. You're not asking them to come down. They'll find you. They'll start finding you. And it just snowballs. If you're not on Google, if you don't have a Google business page, big mistake. Number one search query that comes up, Google business. That will be the first all the time because Google owns Google. Don't know if you know that. So they will always have you at the top. So if you look up Crazy Dogs, it's going to be at the top because he's got a Google My Business page. And it's free. There's little things you can do like that. And you may be feeling overwhelmed and, oh my God, I don't even know where to begin. Let me tell you what you can do. I do analysis go through somebody's situation and try to figure out what the problem is. I call them cart critiques. You'll find many of them already on here where I've done them. Maybe you go through one and you go, dang, I'm doing the same thing that Ted was doing in this video. And Ben told him to change this, and all of a sudden he's booming now. I'm going to do that. those things, if you're in a bind like that and you can't figure it out, holler at me. I can't answer everybody. I can't fix everybody. But if you give me enough information, I will help you. So, and not for a cost. I'll do it for free. But what I'll need you to do, if you're not making money, tell me what the problem is. Ben, I ain't making no money. Or I ain't making enough money. I want to double this kind of money. Then tell me where you are. Where you set up. And if it's two or three locations, I need to know it. Okay? And give me addresses. I'll Google Earth them, Google Map them, I'll look. Then I want some pictures. Get a friend, get a buddy, get a customer, take a picture from across the road and or, you know, nearby you, like three different angles. So I can see the environment that you're working in and how your signs look, okay? Because that's important too. We changed a guy. Let me tell you this real quick. We changed a guy that was at Lowe's. Lowe's, you go, holy cow, how can you fail at Lowe's? You're at Lowe's. You're literally fishing in a stocked pond that's metal surrounded and they can't hide in the weeds. So how do you lose there, right? Well, you lose there by not having any signage. So this feller in our Vendors United group sends me his he actually sent me a short little video. He kind of did a walk around the parking lot showing where he was. He's at the exit door. Perfect spot. Okay? Perfect spot. And he's going, they won't even come up. They just don't even come up to me. They just walk right by me. And so I go, I'm looking at it. And I said, get me some closer up pictures. So he did. Well, I noticed his menu was written about this big. Okay? And it's written neat. I mean, it's very clear, but you have to get up to it to read it. I mean, like 4 or 5 feet away. Well, a lot of people are standoffish because they're like, what is this going on here? Not sure. Don't know. A little scared. I had him do two things. I had him get a regular banner for the front of his table that said, it was a value meal at the time. It says two all beef dogs, drink and chips. And at the time it said $5. Okay. And he put that up and then he put up a swooper flag. Okay. That said hot dogs. Or said lunch, hot lunch. It changed everything for him because now they didn't feel like they had to go up there and get close and be talked to find out what's going on, because a lot of people have never seen a hot dog cart ever. When I put mine in my town, I had more people pulling over to see what the hell I was doing than wanting to buy something. They just couldn't. What kind of contraption is this with steam coming out of it? And so it helped me. A lot of people, though, are a little, you know, they're like, I don't know what he's doing over there. He's probably selling some kind of carpet cleaner, you know, and so they're kind of just hesitant. Well, if you have signs that tell them what you're doing from afar, and you don't need to have your whole menu, make it just big and bold, your main item or your key item, if it's lemonade or funnel cakes or kettle corn, let them know. And a price. Change the price anytime you want, but have a price so that they can see, and then they'll go like, hey, Bob, you want to go over and grab a hot dog, and then we won't even have to wait in line at the Make a D's. And then we'll just head on back to the job site. Well, that's what happens. And it's what happened for him. It changed his entire business with two signs and about $80 in cost, okay, for his banner and his swooper. His banner had to be custom. His swooper just bought it off Amazon, okay? Anyway, I love you. If this helps you or you have things that you would like to share with me about this, I'd love to hear them. Just put them in the comments. You can always email me at ben@vendorsunited.com. If you want, I don't care how good you are, if you want to be better, join vendorsunited.com and be in amongst the best vendors in the world, and everybody's helping everybody, and you get to see some of the craziest stuff, like people serving Beyonce, and a vendor who works for who does all the private gigs for the University of Kentucky, who just started with a cart, okay, and still using a cart. So come join Vendors United, try it out for 5 days free, and it's full access. Even all the courses and stuff that are in there, you get them free because they're free to the vendors. You get them free even though you're going to leave, right? So we give you full access. Just something to think about. It depends on how serious you take it or where you are in the game. Like if you're just starting out or wherever you are and you go, hey, I want to do this. I'm going to invest in myself and do it. I love you, and I will see you next time.